Hello everyone, I'm Umezawa from Showa Hyporima, Singapore. Today, I'll introduce a theory of helix chemistry. This video starts with theory of helix. After that, we answer, when do you choose helix? Compare helix versus RP, reversed phase, and end with summary.Helix is getting popular in HPLC fields recently, and it is often used for polar substance analysis like sugar. Now, let's learn theory for helix chemistry with me. Let me explain theory of helix mode using some images. For helix chemistry, a packing material for calamine is hydrophilic.We use mixture of acetonitrile and water as element. Normally, organic ratio is higher than water. When you flow this mobile phase to calamine, water is gathering to surface of packing material due to hydrophilicity of packing material. Finally, a water layer is created on the surface of packing material. Now, there are two kinds of samples inside calamineWhich have large blue circle part and long yellow bar part. Blue circle suggests hydrophilicity and yellow bar stands for hydrophobicity. This one has large hydrophilic site, so it's totally more hydrophilic. On the other hand, this one has large hydrophobic site, so it's totally more hydrophobic.In case of helix mode, two kinds of interaction happens between sample and packing material. First one is distribution. Element 2, water layer, and water layer 2 element. Distribution happens in here. Hydrophilic sample wants to come into water layer and stay in there longer time because of its hydrophilicity. So it takes time for elution from calamine.On the other hand, hydrophobic sample wants to keep staying mobile phase due to its hydrophobicity. So it is easy to flow through the calamine with element flow. Second one is hydrophilic interaction. Hydrophilic interaction is here. The surface of packing material is hydrophilic, so hydrophilic samples retain strongly and take time to elute out.On the other hand, hydrophobic sample does not retain well, so it is easy to elute out. Under helix condition, we can separate samples with both two interactions, distribution and hydrophilic interaction. Now we could understand the theory for helix mode. So let's confirm how samples are separated by helix mode.Please focus on hydrophobic one first. This one didn't interact with packing material so much, so it eluted out from calamine earlier. Now hydrophilic one, please look at how to move. Hydrophilic sample interacted with packing material a lot and took longer path, so it takes longer time to elute out from calamine.Please refer to this chromatogram. Hydrophobic one is detected earlier and hydrophilic one is detected later. We can separate samples with hydrophilic interaction under helix condition. Please remember, elution order is hydrophobic to hydrophilic. Next topic is when do you choose helix? The answer is,Helix is suitable for hydrophilic substances. So please choose helix mode when your sample is hydrophilic. The most popular application for helix is sugar, such as mono G trisaccharides and sugar alcohol. Saccharides are hydrophilic because they have OH group in their structure. Reversed phase orRP chromatography is most popular in HPLC field, but it uses hydrophobic interaction. So it is not compatible for hydrophilic substance like sugar analysis. Here, we have a table comparing the features of helic versus reversed phase. The stationary phase is polar or hydrophilic. The mobile phase is similar, but with more organic solvent ratio. And retention can be controlled by changing the ratio of the mobile phase. As you can see, helic is almost the exact opposite of reversed phase. Now, we come to summary. We have learned three things about helic in this video. First one, helic is suitable for hydrophilic substance. And most popular application is saccharides and sugar alcohol. I'll introduce application in our next video. Chemistry for separation involves distribution between water layer and mobile phase, and hydrophilic interaction. Finally, elution order is hydrophobic to hydrophilic. Please visit our Shodex website for more. You can check out product information and many application data. I believe it will be useful for your projects. Please subscribe to our channel. I will update new video soon. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one.